In this video, I'll show you how neurons use a structure called myelin to speed up the transmission of electrical signals. Then, I'll give you one good reason why you should care a lot about myelin by introducing you to a debilitating disease known as multiple sclerosis, in which the myelin is damaged and destroyed. In the last video, we saw how neurons without myelin need to use voltage-gated sodium channels to start an action potential at every single part of the axon. So, an action potential needs to be started here, then here, and so on. But generating an action potential at every single part of the axon requires much more time and much more energy. To make these electrical signals travel faster, we can replace many of these voltage-gated channels with a structure called myelin. So let's zoom out a bit to see where this myelin is coming from. Myelin is a structure that is made by a group of support cells in your nervous system known as glial cells. Glia are cells in your nervous system that are not neurons and do not send electrical signals, but they do help support the proper functioning of your neurons. In that way, they serve as the glue that helps hold the entire nervous system together. In fact, the word glia comes from the word meaning glue. And I like to think of them as the unsung heroes of your nervous system. Neurons seem to get all the credit, they're really popular, but glia are super important to help neurons function. There are actually a few different types of glial cells in your nervous system that serve a variety of purposes. For example, helping to fight infection. But the ones we're gonna talk about are the glial cells that help form myelin. The two types of myelin-forming glial cells are known as oligodendrocytes, which form myelin in the central nervous system, or CNS, and Schwann cells, which form myelin in the peripheral nervous system, or PNS. In the picture in the top left here, you can see how the glial cells in orange wrap themselves around the axon of a neuron to form the myelin structure. You can actually see the myelin under the microscope as well. So if we look at this real image, which is a cross-section showing the axons coming out towards you, you can see many axons in this picture, each surrounded by a thick layer. And notice how it's not just one single layer. Instead, one glial cell, either an oligodendrocyte or a Schwann cell, has repeatedly wrapped itself around an axon to form this tight, repeating, thick myelin wrapping. So if we zoom back out, you'll notice though that this wrapping and this myelin is not on the entire axon. There are these small blue sections of exposed axon that do not have myelin. And these are known as the nodes, or nodes of Ranvier. These nodes are the only place on the axon where we have voltage-gated channels, and so they are the only place where we can generate action potentials. So now that we have the structure down, let's see how myelin and these nodes help electrical signals spread so much more quickly. Just like always, we start the first action potential using some initial stimulus or graded potential. If this signal is strong enough and makes this first node positive enough, the voltage-gated sodium channels will open, allowing sodium to enter and starting the first action potential at this first node. After the sodium has entered the cell though, it will begin to diffuse down the axon. Normally, diffusion is a terrible way to send electrical signals. Diffusion over long distances is extremely slow, and diffusion of electrical charge will lose a lot of strength as it travels, as we've mentioned in past videos. But that's where this myelin comes in really, really handy. Myelin provides an insulating layer, which prevents these ions from leaking out of the cell. And in fact, I like to think of myelin like a comfortable sweater you put on when you're cold. Sweaters help insulate your body by trapping heat and preventing it from escaping. Myelin does the same thing, but instead of trapping heat, it's gonna trap positive charge. So when someone asks you to explain what myelin does, just say it's like a sweater for your neurons. So myelin forces the sodium to stay inside the axon, keeping that positive charge signal strong and concentrated. But because of this, the diffusion of these sodium ions actually occurs very quickly, almost instantaneously through this section of myelin, quickly reaching the next node. Because of this, the electrical signal remained very strong and strong enough to open up the next set of voltage-gated sodium channels at the next node. Then we just do the same thing over again. Sodium ions enter the axon at the next node, starting another action potential, and this positive charge will diffuse quickly through the next section of myelin, losing very little strength thanks to the myelin insulating the axon. Eventually, that signal reaches the final node and continues the electrical signal down the line. So what you notice is that once we start an action potential at this first node in a neuron with myelin, we no longer have to generate an action potential at every single part of the axon. The action potentials seem to jump from node to node, skipping over the myelinated sections. And this process of action potentials jumping like this is known as saltatory conduction. Saltatory comes from a word meaning to jump or to skip, and that's exactly what these action potentials are doing. They are jumping from node to node, skipping over the myelinated portions. And saltatory conduction is actually pretty awesome, because not only does it help speed up the electrical signals, since now the electrical signals are jumping from node to node much more quickly, it also means that we save energy. Action potentials require a lot of metabolic energy. The fewer action potentials we have to generate, the more energy we'll save. That's pretty cool, right? But to really help drive home just how important this myelin is, I wanted to give you another reason to care a lot about myelin. So we know myelin helps keep these sodium ions inside the axon, which speeds up signal transmission. But to prove to you how important this is, let's look at multiple sclerosis, a debilitating neurodegenerative disease in which the oligodendrocytes, remember the myelin-forming cells in the central nervous system, are attacked, damaged, and potentially lost. If the myelin is damaged, which usually happens when the body's own immune system attacks these cells, this positive charge and these sodium ions can now leak out of the cell as they diffuse down the axon. This means the traveling signal will weaken much more than normal. As this damage gets worse, it might lead to the signal weakening so much that by the time it reaches the next node, it might no longer be strong enough to trigger the next action potential. The traveling signal will then just continue to weaken as it diffuses to the right. So the final node in this picture will also not receive a strong enough stimulus, will not open the sodium channels, and the electrical signal will eventually just die off and end. So the damage to the myelin means that this neuron will be unable to send or propagate signals where they need to go. But what if this neuron was responsible for triggering muscle contractions, helping you move? Well, if the signal dies in this neuron and never reaches the end of the axon, that means the signal will definitely not reach the muscle itself, making it hard for this person to contract and control their muscles. And that's the basis of multiple sclerosis, a debilitating disease caused simply by losing this all-important structure known as myelin. And if you want to learn more, I've posted a link in the description below that includes interviews from patients with multiple sclerosis describing their symptoms.